Okay, we find ourselves now having come as far as verse number 7 in Luke 10. We're taking a look there at the way to advance missions, to make our movement forward in getting the gospel throughout the world. And here in verse number 7, the Bible says, "Eating and drinking such things as they give you, for the labor is worthy of his hire." And it tells us there to remain in that house. Not to go about from place to place, but remain in that house. Our fourth and final principle here, and it is a principle, it's not so much a law, but it's something that you and I need to spend some time seriously trying to figure out how to work out in practical living. What Christ said to his disciples there, those 70 that he sent out, was very simply this, that as they went from house to house, they were to announce their purpose. And that purpose was then to discern where they should enter in. If they were received by that Son of Peace, he then would usher them into a group of others who would be open to the gospel, and you'd be able to give it to the whole household, not just family, but friends and those that person and that household influences. But now, our final principle, verse 7 here, is to discern according to their purpose. Not our purpose, but their purpose. And if indeed they receive us into the house, do they then make some provisions? Now here we're not so much talking about, are they going to pay all our bills? Are they going to support us for the rest of our life? That's not what we're after. Certainly when you come from a place like America, which is seen around the world as a very rich country, and you go to third world places where people are very poor, you and I might very quickly draw the conclusion we should pay all the bills and cover all the expenses and never expect anything out of them. That's not what Jesus said. He said we should eat what's set before us, eating and drinking what's given to us, and the emphasis here is on what they give, what they invest in getting this gospel. Indeed, if these folks are serious about receiving the gospel, they will make some provisions so that you and I, as we take the gospel, will recognize, if we're paying attention, if we're watching, we will recognize their sacrifice. I've used the illustration before of one of our men, Layson, who we were meeting in the market for quite some time. It was just underneath a tree or under a shelter or out in the open, just on the pavement, sometimes in the dirt. We never knew where we were going to meet from week to week. And in order for our folks to sit, they had to sit on the ground. And so when I would come to teach each Sunday morning, one of our men, Layson, would come and he would bring a stool for me to sit on while I taught. I asked him where the stool was coming from, where it was at, where it was kept, and he said he carried it from his house, which would be about a 2-mile trip for him, carried it from his house to the meeting place every Sunday morning in order that I might have a place to sit while others were sitting on the ground. Sign of respect, sacrifice on his part, yes, all of that. And I realized that though the stool was not a throne, it was treated like one. He was giving of himself. He was sacrificing. And in the midst of all that, I asked him the question. I said, "Why do you do that?" He said, "Because I want to hear the Word of God, and I'm thankful that you have come and taught us." And so it was his way of honoring me and honoring the gospel. Friend, that tells me that's the household to stay in. Not go running around everywhere else like a chicken with your head cut off, but invest in that household so that they become disciplers of men and reproducing themselves as well. Powerful, powerful passage. And when we ignore this, when we just go providing everything, and I think there's an awful lot to be said here about indigenous missions and the importance of us not paying all the bills and getting to the place to where we support the nationals, and that's a whole nother discussion. But when we get to that place, we end up buying people off, and we end up with disciples who come because of cash rather than maybe because of Christ. But we can't tell the difference because we're giving them money. Well, leave you with those thoughts, all right. Thanks so much for joining me for this series. I trust that it's been a challenge and something to give you some grist for your mental mill, if you will, and some serious consideration for the advancement of missions in our world in this day. God bless you.